from the National Air and Space Museum, and I'm here to bring some of our museum stories to you at home. Today I'm thinking about the solar system. The planets and the sun are the most famous parts of the solar system, but there are lots of other smaller objects orbiting on our sun. Asteroids are rocky, and they can be anywhere, but many asteroids orbit together just past Mars in an area called the asteroid belt. Comets are icy, and they travel all the way from the coldest part of the solar system and orbit on a path that comes close to the sun. Some of these come from the Kuiper belt, where Pluto is, and some from even farther away. It's not easy to see comets with just your eyes, so people have used telescopes to find and learn about them. Carolyn Herschel discovered new comets using her brother William's telescopes. Here's a picture of one of the telescopes that they used to observe the skies. Another way to look closely at objects from space is to bring them to Earth. The Stardust mission collected interstellar dust and small particles or bits of a comet in an amazing material called aerogel. The gel was placed inside the Stardust capsule and launched into space in a rocket. Stardust passed through the dust and comet particles, and they were caught in the gel. The capsule with the bits of comet dust returned to Earth with the help of a parachute. One thing you might know about comets is that they have a tail. When comets get near the sun, some of the ice turns to vapor and looks like a tail. Small bits of dust from the comets can become meteoroids that we see in meteor showers as they burn up in our atmosphere on Earth. Here's a story about a comet. Once upon a time, there was a round comet in the Kuiper Belt named Temple Tuttle. The comet liked to travel long distances and was preparing to take a really long trip all the way to the sun and back. While she was getting ready to leave, she went to visit her neighbor Pluto. "Oh, hey Pluto, I was just swinging by on my way. I'm going to visit the sun." Pluto said, "Wow, the sun is a hot star. Sounds fun, but I would rather stay out here in the Kuiper Belt where it's nice and cold. I have enough fun on my tilted orbit. See you soon." The comet waved and then began swinging out towards the sun. It was a long trip, but there was so much to see. There were icy worlds with beautiful stars and galaxies shining in the distance. Soon the comet came by the giant icy planets Neptune and Uranus. They were so big that they didn't notice Temple Tuttle as she passed by. "Such beautiful, big, icy planets," thought the comet. Then the comet came upon the gas giants Saturn and Jupiter. They were even bigger. She waved to some of their moons as she passed them. Next, she came to the asteroid belt. She wanted to say hello to Ceres, who lived here. Ceres was a dwarf planet like Pluto. She saw Ceres and called, "Hello? Hello, are you here for the race?" asked Ceres. "No, just passing through. I'm off to see the sun," answered Temple Tuttle. "Oh, well, we always have fun racing around the asteroid belt. Can you stay for a bit?" said Ceres. There were a whole group of asteroids in the asteroid belt whirling around. They had set up an oval racetrack for a big race around the sun. The comet decided to stay a moment to watch the big race. And they were off! So many asteroids of all different sizes and shapes were zooming around on the racetrack. Oh no! Temple Tuttle saw two asteroids knock right into each other. Bits of rock flew off of them. "Are you okay?" called Temple Tuttle. "We're okay!" they shouted out together and picked themselves back up to get back in the race. They looked around and saw Temple Tuttle. "Bye-bye!" the two asteroids said together as they raced off. "Those two," said Ceres. "They're always close together. Well, I'm going to join the race. See you later." "See you," said Temple Tuttle as she continued toward Mars and the inner planets. Mars looked cool in his sunglasses, and Earth looked peaceful spinning around with their moon. The comet waved to each planet as she passed, but she wasn't sure they saw her. As she passed Venus and Mercury, she could feel the sun's warmth. It made her feel different, a bit squishy. She looked back away from the sun and noticed that she had a long tail. "What's that?" she wondered. "Is that part of me?" She knew she had to keep going toward the sun. She looked ahead and could see the sun getting closer. The sun was so incredibly huge and warm. "Hello, beautiful sun. I came from far away to see you," the comet said shyly. "Oh, Temple Tuttle, there you are. Hello, it's good to see you," answered the sun. The sun pulled the comet in and gave her a big hug. Then the sun swung the comet back around out into space. "Whee! What fun! I love swinging," called Temple Tuttle. "Goodbye, lovely comet. Come back to see me again," said the sun. "I will," answered the comet, and she turned away from the sun. She saw her long, sparkly tail. "I feel different. and I look different too. I like it, thought the comet to herself. The comet continued to travel back away from the sun. As the comet passed by Earth, bits of dust and ice rained down into Earth's atmosphere. Earth smiled and waved at the comet. Looking good, Temple Tuttle. I see you. See you next time, said Temple Tuttle as she swung back toward the colder parts of the solar system. Her tail started to fade, but she knew that she could grow it again with another swing around the sun. It's fun to change your look sometimes, but I'm always me inside, thought the little comet. It's craft time. Today we're going to make telescopes. What you need for this activity is a paper towel tube. You're going to need some color tape and some colored paper. And I have some blue colored paper that I'm going to use, and scissors and crayons. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to cover our paper towel tube, and that's going to make it a little bit more sturdy and a little nicer. So I like to use just a half a piece of this construction paper. I fold it right in half like that, and this is just the right size to cover my paper towel tube. So the first thing I'm going to do is, before I put it on, I'm going to draw some decorations on my paper, and that's going to be easier to draw before I put it on the paper towel tube than it is after. But you can also draw after, whichever one you like, but I think it's a little bit easier to put the drawings on first. So I'm drawing some swirly white lines on there, and I put some red stars. Let's see, maybe I'll put some yellow ones as well, and some orange. That's gonna be, I think, really nice on my telescope. Do whatever designs you like and make it look just the way you want it to look. So there we go, that's my design. Now I'm going to put that design right onto my paper towel tube. So I'm going to take it on here, and just to make it a little bit easier, I'm going to take a piece of tape and secure that paper right onto the tube so it doesn't move around while I'm trying to wrap it around. So I have two small pieces of tape, and I'm going to take that tape and put one piece right here to secure it, and one piece down here. There we go. Now it stays while I'm trying to wrap it right around. And now it can wrap it all the way around. And now I'm going to use a bit of tape going all the way down to hold that on. Some tape over here. Put that right on, going right down the line of where the paper attaches. There we go. Now I'm going to put some tape around the edges so that will hold it onto the paper towel tube really well. And I think it looks pretty neat that way too. That's a good telescope. There's the top, and let's put one on the bottom too. You can use as much tape as you like to decorate it, because the colored tape looks really cool too, as well as being great for keeping things on. There we go. I have a little bit of extra here at the top, and I can cover that with tape or cut it off, whichever way I want to do. I'm just going to cover it with more tape so that it doesn't show. Now you can use your telescopes that you make this way to look out at things in your house or at the stars at nighttime and the moon and look for comets. When you look through the telescope, you're going to see a circle, and it'll help you to focus on just what's in that circle. So try it out and let us know how you do making your telescopes and what you can see. Bye-bye.